podcast. Today we're doing Future Bass, and let's hope it's a good one. Okay, one retro boy to get us started. You want to adjust the envelope, give it some glide, change the LFO, because you want that pop, pop, pop. I don't know that sound. Okay, it works. Make some chords. Oh, that's wrong. Up an octave, sorry. So that's the most generic sound you're gonna get, but obviously you can change the color. I hate the green. Also, we need to add some layers. And it's the sound, it's got that fuller, that more epic sound. It's like it's a stadium. What a concert, whatever. And then here you want to adjust the LFO rate. Also, it's just boring. So you see I'm changing it faster, slower, faster. You can make it really fast. What am I doing? There we go. And now the EQ. You want one synth with the high end and then one cut the low end, so it kind of they help each other with the frequencies. Do it again with this one, and then calm down. My cat. Some 808s. Just use the root notes from the chords. Standard procedures. And then you want to get a sine bass or sub even lower than that, and just layer it. There we go. That's my favorite one. You can use stock plugins, really makes no difference, as long as it sounds good. So with one bass, yeah, they're like slightly off time, but they complement it. I mean the vocals help. So here I've got a cappella, Selena Gomez on. Now you wanna change the pitch to fit your song, obviously, because it's not just gonna fit unless you're lucky, and also for copyright. So it doesn't fit, so let's just change it. And then go flex pitch, and then what you do, you click that little DNA sign, and then you select all the notes. And then you move the recording. Sorry, my cat. And then bounce it, because you want the audio file. You don't want to control E for that. You don't want to have to use the flex pitch file, because it messes stuff up. You want to bounce. Also save CPU. And here, we just have the random selection, and we just make a vocal chop. Okay, I'm back. Yeah, I made one. Okay, now once you're done the vocal, let's make the kick. You want like a really punchy kick. So yeah, I made a little kick pattern. And I just put the riser. Now for the snare, I liked using tonal snares. I'll show you how to do that. Just layer it with my hand. And then sidechain the snare and the kick. For this, I didn't add it to a bus. Because just for tutorial sake, just add it to the master channel. It does just fine. It's not like we need it to sound perfect. Okay, and then get hi-hats. Easy. Just create a... Okay, now you want something else in the melody. So here I'm using... or pizzicato reflections. It sounds good. There's the paper. Enjoy your.